Amanini working as an assistant professor in St. Martin's Engineering College. Today we are talking about two lessons at a time, words often confused and 10 English grammar common errors. Okay, so first we go with words often confused. So in English language we have lot of confusing words. So we generally confuse with all the words since we are non-native speakers, and we confuse with all the confusing words whatever we have. So we'll see some of the few words about all the confusing things. So first one is anyway and anyway. So anyway with space and anyway without space. So here anyway without space, first we talk about this. So in this word, what is the difference between both anyway and anyway? So first we speak about this with space anyway. So here anyway means all the possible ways. So if I just tell you one sentence to define this word. So here, so anyway, you have to get there on time anyway. So use all the possible methods, all the possible ways, and get there on time. So if I am particularly telling that you have to get there on time, so that comes under this space anyway, and anyway without space. So this is in case, in any case. So it can be like I am not at all going to share you any information. So whatever, so you are not trustworthy. So I am not at all going to share in any information. So that comes under this. I am not at all going to share information anyway. So that way, that is the both difference between both the words anyway with space and without space. So the next word is born and born. The word born, born here is to come into this world, to be born. So example, a baby girl was born in my sister's house. So it's like describing a child to be born into this world. So we can use this word born. And whenever it comes to the word born, born, so it is like to bear with. So it is having a child or having a person or anything. So having something is comes under this born. So it can be like my sister has born a baby boy. So she is having a baby boy. So in this, he was born into this world. So that way we can use this, and it is having a particular person or particular thing. We can use this born, born. The next word is censored. Censure. So here censor, S-O-R-E and S-U-R-E. This is the main difference between both the words. So here censor, when it comes to the word censor, so this means to delete or monitor some information or anything. So generally in movies we hear few of the censor videos, censor deleted scenes. So all comes under this word censor. So it can be used like this. So like the documents, if you want to delete few of the documents, you can use this. I decided to censor the document. So here I am using this as deleting or monitoring particular document or particular information, whatever it may be. So that comes under this word censor. And censure, when it comes to censure, the unfavorable words, unfavorable talks that hurts the other person. So if you are hurting a person, so generally media, when you consider the media, so if an ordinary person goes into the media with some of the issues, so generally they give few of the comments which hurts the person. So that comes under this. So unfavorable talks which hurts the persons is called as the word censure. Okay, that is the difference between both. So the to delete something or and unfavorable talks that hurts the persons comes with this words. And the next word is confident and confident. So So generally the word confident, so everybody knows this word actually. So confident is, confidence. So believing in yourself. If you believe in yourself, you use the word confident. So self-assurance, believing in yourself, all comes under this word confident. So I can use this like this. So she is a confident young woman. Okay, so you can describe this word like that. So the next word is confidant. So this comes like this. So if a trustworthy person, the secret person, the trustworthy person, so whom you believe, so whatever the information you share to him, so if he don't carry that particular information to others, so that is called as confidant. So if I share something with you and you don't reveal that particular information with others, that comes under this. So I can give an example like this. So Jack in the first floor is my confidant. So I can share whatever information I want with him. So that I can call that particular person as confidant. So that is the main difference between both. And the next word is biannual and biennial. So here biannual, the word biannual, so here it is, so the word consists the meaning, so the word contains the meaning already. So bi means two and annual means year. So if you are giving a particular information or conducting a particular thing twice a year is called as biannual. So if I consider a company, I can give you an example like this. The company of the company. So the company gives every 6 months the progress report. So company gives you the progress report every 6 months. So the company provides biannually particular information. So that comes under this. And biennial. So when you consider the word biennial, so here it is twice. It is like once in 2 years. Once in 2 years comes under the word biennial. So in this word you are considering twice a year and once 2 years. So okay, so once in 2 years. So all the football matches or any sports national matches, every two years they'll conduct a few of the games. So football matches and all, they comes under this biennial. So here I can use it as like the football matches conducted biennial. So the football match, football cup event conducted biennially. So this comes under this word. And the next word is bath and bathe. So here bath and bathe. So the word bath here is body wash. Every day we wash our body, so that comes under this word bath. And what is the word bathe? So here we are washing each and every part of the body. And when it comes to the word bathe, so we are washing only a particular part of the body. So if my toes hurt, if I can tell you an example like this. So my toes are hurting. So I just wanted to have a hot water bath. Okay, so I can use that way. So I am applying water to my toes, only a particular part of the body. So I am only applying there because my toes are hurting. So this is complete body wash and it is applying water to a particular body. So that is the difference between both bath and bath. Next one is canvas and canvas. So the main difference is S, single S and double S. We have the word differentiation here. So the word canvas. So here the word canvas is a piece of, a type of cloth actually. Canvas is a type of cloth where the artistic work done. Okay, so painters do the their artistic work on canvas cloth. Or the artist, the embroidery works, all those comes under this canvas cloth. So if you are having a canvas cloth, you can use this word canvas. and the word canvas here with double s. So what this means is canvassing, asking for support. So politically, politicians go for support, ask for support. So that canvassing is called as the word canvas with double s. Let's go to other word, fewer and less. So what this means? So fewer and less both gives you the same meaning, that is less. So when we use this fewer and when we use this less. So whenever you are using countable things, you have to use this fewer. Whenever you are using uncountable things, you have to use less. So fewer, if I am counting the benches, I am counting the computers, chairs, so I should use this fewer. Fewer chairs, fewer benches. So if I am using uncountable things like sugar, water, okay, so powder, so all comes under this less, okay, uncountable and countable. Next one is allusion and illusion. So this word allusion here means, so allusion, if you are referring to a particular person or if you are referring something to a thing, so that comes under this allusion. Referring to something is called as, if I am referring to a small kid, so a mom's kid, so I am referring to that particular child, that comes under this allusion. What does this illusion? So illusion means imagining something. Okay, if I have so the illusion done by the illusion created by the magician took my breath away. Okay, whatever the illusion, the imagination, whatever the magician do, the artistic things, okay, that don't exist actually, so that comes under this illusion. The imagination is called as illusion, and if you are referring something to is called as illusion. So these are often confused words generally we have in our English language. So we can have a lot of words also, but I picked a few of them and for this explanation. So let's go to the other topic. So 10 grammar common mistakes. So again, so non-native speakers and native speakers, I have to mention this sentence because non-native speakers always confuse with all the words grammatically, vocabulary, way. So we have lot of confusion with the words and we have lot of confusion with the usage of the sentences. So every non-native speaker faces this type of problems generally, so that is not at all a big issue, but so practice makes man perfect. So first one, my good name is. So my good name is, the usage of my good name is completely wrong. Okay, so whenever you are introducing yourself to a person, do not introduce yourself with my good name, my myself. Don't go and start your introduction with my good name is, because we don't have good name and bad name. So if you don't go to a person, if you go to a person and ask him what is your good name, and you have to go to other person and ask him that what is your bad name. So if you can't ask what is your bad name, you can't ask what is your good name too. Okay, so that is the difference between both. So okay, if there is no bad name, there is no good name. Okay, name is name. So you shouldn't use all such type of sentences, because what is your name? My name is. If you want to, so especially when you go to when you go to the interviews and all, avoid such type of English language. So my good name is, you can add a few things, you can remove this word good, and you can use it like this. My name is Amani. Simple. So keep it as simple as it is. My name is Amani. So or else, my name is Amani, or this is Amani, I am Amani. But never use it as myself or my good name is. Okay, that is completely wrong. So you have to give a observation on that. next thing is so I am 26 year old. So what is wrong in this sentence? So everybody feel it like this. So nothing wrong in this sentence, but you have a wrong word here, ear, because I am talking about a person. I am talking about myself. I am a human being. So if you are talking about a human being, so you should always go with plural thing. If you are using non-living things, you have to go with ear. So suppose if I have a table in my house, I can use it like this. So that table is 26 year old, but here I am a human being. I am still living and I am telling my age. So I am 26 years old. Okay, years old. You should not use the singular formats for non-living things. You have to always go with plural things whenever you are using a particular person's age. Okay, next thing is so my cousin brother, my real sister. So here cousin is a cousin and sister is a sister. Never use the word cousin, brother and real sister, because so here cousin, the word itself is telling you that he does not belong to your parents, your own parents. So cousin belongs to other family. Your own sister and brother belongs to you, comes under a different thing. If you are using this cousin, never use this brother, because you can use the sentence like this. If he is my cousin, she is my cousin. So directly you are telling, if you are using he, that person obviously is a boy. If you are using she, obviously she is a girl. So okay, never use this brother. So this is the wrong thing, because my cousin is the right thing. And my real sister, my blood sister, so all such type of things is wrong again. So you don't have a duplicate sister, so and you don't have a real sister. You have a sister, okay, that's it. So if you want to you add up few things to that, you can add it like this: elder sister, younger sister, or else only sister. She is my only sister. So that is more better than, much better than this real sister. Okay, stop using such things. I give you an information. So again here it may look correct to few of the people, but it is not again correct thing. So here an is the wrong usage, because the information what here we are using is an adjective, and it is it comes under uncountable noun. Okay, so whenever you are using uncountable nouns, so avoid using articles. Okay, before uncountable nouns, so you should not use an articles. Okay, articles never comes before uncountable nouns. So you have to, that is the rule of English language, you can't change it. So stop using that. The next thing is so one of my friend going to NASA. So this is again the wrong usage, because if you are talking about, if you are using the word one of, you are talking about a lot of people at the same time. If my hand has five fingers, so if I am talking about a particular finger, then I am talking about all of the other fingers, one of my finger. I am talking about one of my finger from all the other things. If you are talking about a particular friend, one of my friend, you are talking about all of your friends, a lot of people at the same time. So you are picking one among them. So one among that person. So a person. That's why if you are using this one of, you have to use it like this. Friends. So one of my friends going to NASA. Okay, let's go for a walk. So again, this is again wrong sentence, because whenever you are looking at the word for, the preposition for, so always verb plus ing. So you have to avoid the ing format whenever you are looking at the preposition for. Okay, let's go for walk. So verb is enough in this sentences. Do not add ing format whenever you are using this word for, the preposition for. Okay, this is the wrong usage in your English language. Okay, next thing, the flight is leaving in 10 minutes. So here the flight is leaving in 10 minutes, so the tense is wrong here. So whenever you are talking about tenses, so always, so you should be like, whenever you are talking about a particular timetable or schedule, whatever it may be. So here we are talking about 10 minutes, particularly we are talking only about 10 minutes, okay. So the flight is leaving in 10 minutes, we are talking about a particular timetable, okay. So we should not use this type of tense here. We should always go with simple present tense in the English language. Okay, so mentioning any timetable or schedule, so you have to always go with simple present tense. The flight leaves in 10 minutes. So the flight leaves in 10 minutes. Next thing, I drove my bike very fast to reach here. So here, I drove my bike very fast here. So nothing wrong in this sentence, but okay. So whenever you are talking about a bike, okay. So we ride a bike and we drive a car, okay. So whenever you are talking about a bike, we always ride it. We don't drive it, okay. So riding a bike, driving a car. Okay, so this is the wrong usage. I ride my bike very fast to reach here. Okay, so these are few of the English common grammar mistakes. So this is how about we talk in English.